Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make what we call a fortune teller. When we were kids, you'd just have your numbers or a colour on here, and then you'd spell it out or count it, and then pick one, and then spell that out or count it. And then when you've done your second time, you'd pick one, pick it up, and find a forfeit or a funny joke or something in that area. Something that we did as kids when back in the 80s and 90s, and I still think it's fun for kids to do nowadays, so I'm going to show you how to do it. You can start with just a piece of origami square paper, but if you don't have origami square paper, you can do it with a piece of A4 paper. There's two ways to make a square from A4 paper. You can either fold it over like that, but then you'll end up with a crease down here, which you might not want. So what you can do is use two pieces of paper, and if you put one lined up perfectly to the edge of the other, that way round, so that this is all meeting up along here, then you can cut off the extra strip down there with a ruler and a blade. Line it up correctly. So you line it up like this, and you want to carefully slice it off. Be careful, an adult should do this part. Make sure you're right on the edge of that paper. Make sure you close your blade down. You now have your square piece of paper. I'll show you how to make it in this one so that you can see on the bigger piece compared to an origami piece, which of course is much smaller, so it's choice which one. You could cut this into four and have even smaller ones, but that makes it more fiddly for the kids, so better to work with the bigger pieces. What you want to do to start with is you need to find your centre, so fold over in half and open it again, turn it around and do the same process again so you end up with a cross at the centre. You've got this. So what you want to do is turn it so you're at an angle, and this point wants to go to the middle section, the intersection of these two creases that you've made. So you're just going to line that up. The line should go down this crease and down this crease. You're going to want to do that all of the corners. So just turn around, pick up, line it up, if it goes slightly off, try to get it as close as possible, turn and again. Final time. So now you can see you've got all of them folded in like that. You want to turn it over. And you can see the crease marks again, and we're going to be doing the same thing, but this time we're folding up to here along this crease line, so against it. So we're going up to the middle again, turn and again up to the middle, and try to keep it straight as you can, because that will make it easier for moving it later. Final one up to the middle. Now you've got them all folded over this side, and this side you've got your little pockets. So what I'm going to do is fold this in half along that line. Give it a good fold down. And then open it back up, turn around and fold that way. Now that pocket's going to fold. But what you want to do now, it's a little tricky, but what you do is you want to open up these pockets on both sides, and this line here you want to crease it down, and you want to do the same on this side, put things in, bend along that line, and then you want to push together along these lines. There we go, like that. And there is your fold. On the underside it looks like that. So give good creases along there, and your finger and thumbs just fit in along there on both sides, and then you're just going to open. And then you can just fill them in, and you can put, you can choose anything you want, but you can put something like one. So they can see them, and you can pick which one. So if someone says two, there's a choice. You can either go one, two, or you can spell it out. So you can go T-W-O. And either way, they pick the next one. So you open this up, and then you can do, say, colours. So, and you could colour these with actual pens with the kids, so they can do different colours for each section. So we can go blue. You might want to turn these around. Green. Yellow. You can use any colours you like. Pink. A purple. Orange. So violet. So if someone said three, you can go one, two, three, and then they can pick between yellow, orange, violet or green. So if we say yellow, we go Y-E-L-L-O-W. And then you pick which one to flick up. So say orange, and you pick it up and you see what it says there. So to do them, you just want to open it up, and then you can write anything you like in here. So it can be pretty things. You can go, so you can have nice things, or you can have forfeits. So pop on the spot. You of course would write these much neater, I'm just doing it for quickly, but you get the idea. So you can put whatever you like in these sections for the kids to do. When they do your little choosing, you can then just open up whichever ones you want and pick the spot. So that's a fun little one for the kids to do. And it says you can do dots, you can choose whatever you like on there, and you can even colour these ones in different colours, which is be good fun for the kids to draw, and then put anything in if you like. And on origami paper, this is the size it would be if you used the origami paper. So just, you see, it makes quite a different size. So this one's much easier for the kids to use. But if you've got older children, they might be alright with the smaller ones. And you do the same thing on these, on this one. Yeah, thank you.